Hello guys, I hope you are all doing well. In this video, we are going to talk about two library functions which are fread and fwrite. These library functions are generally used to write binary data to a file and read binary data from a file. So let's begin. Before going to these two functions, I would advise you to watch the previous video in which I had told you the difference between the text file and binary file and also explained you how the binary data is actually stored in the file. Okay, that will make your concept more clear. Okay, now first of all, we will see how the fwrite function and fread function is used, and after that we will talk about the prototype of these two functions. Right, now let's say we want to write the binary data, and to write the binary data we use the fwrite function. Okay, so first of all I will open the file fopen with the mode wb. Okay, wb means writing in binary mode. Okay, then I will check if fp not equals to null, right? That means the file has been successfully opened. Okay, now we will use fwrite function. So I'll write here fwrite, then I have to pass here four arguments. In the first argument I will send the address from where the data needs to be sent. Okay, for example, let's say here in an array the base address is 1992 and I'm considering integer of 4 byte, then the next will be 1996, then 2000 and then 2004. Okay, so I want the data to be sent from this location, so I'll send the address as end of A. Right, at the end we sent at which file you want to write the data. So I want to write in this file. Okay, so I'll write here fp. Okay, we have to specify the file stream here. Okay, now in the second argument I have to tell it how many bytes of data you want to write. Okay, now let's say I want to write the 4 byte of data, so I'll write 4. Okay, and then here I have to tell how many consecutive this location you want to write. For example, if I write here 2, then first of all it will write 4 byte of data to the file and then it will again write the next 4 byte of data to a file. Okay, so now let's say here was 97, here it is 98, 99 and 100. Okay, so now first of all let's say that I had written here 8 and 1. Okay, now it means that send 8 bytes of data starting from this location. Okay, and do it only once. So what will happen, this is 4 byte and this is 4 byte, right? So this much amount of data in binary format will be written to the disk. Okay, now let's say instead of 1 I'm writing here 2. Now what will happen, first these 8 byte of data will be written and after that next 8 byte of data will be written. Okay, 8 byte and 8 byte, right? Now for the same thing you can also write here 16 1. Okay, so 16 byte of data only the one time will be sent. Okay, now if I'm writing here 2, in the next memory 16 block will be written and that we don't know what will be the data here, so there will be some garbage written to the file. Okay, so here we write how many bytes of data you want to write and here how many number of time the same byte you want to write. Okay, again if I say here 4 and let's say I'll write here 3, then first it will write 4 byte of data, so 97 will be written, and then next 4 byte of data, so 98, and then next 99. Okay, so 3 times the 4 byte of data is going to be written. Okay, and now the total size of the data which is written is 12 byte. Okay, 4 byte for each integer. Okay, or you can do 4 into 3, right? Number of byte and how many number of times you want to write data to the file. So now let's say I'm writing the whole data with one byte at a time. Okay, and 97, 98, 99, 100 in the binary form will be written. Now for the same program, let's say how can I read the data present in this file temp.bin. So I'll open the file fopen with the name temp.bin and then I'll open it in read binary mode and then I'll check if fp not equals to null. This we also do in the text files also, okay, that we had already seen previously, right? Then I will do fread and then it will also take the four arguments. Now in the first argument, you have to specify the address in which the data is going to be written, that is read. Okay, so let's say here is an integer variable int a. Okay, and whatever I am reading from the file, it should be, the value should be stored in this variable. So I'll give the address of this variable, right? Now in the last argument will be the file stream. Okay, now in the first, in the second argument, I will write here how many bytes you want to read. So let's say I want to read here 4 bytes. Okay, and how many number of times you want to read. So let's say I want only want it to be happen read only one time. Okay, so what will happen now, this 4 bytes, the first 4 bytes will be read by our fread function, and the value which it will return will be 97, and 97 is going to be assigned to the variable a. Okay, so after that, if I write here only printf and then write here %d and a, then it will give me output as 97. Okay, now let's say I want to read this data and store it in some array. Okay, so what I will do, I will create an array. Let's say the size of the array is A5 and I want to read this 16 byte. Now again, either I can do here 16 1, or I can write 8 2, or I can write here 4 4. Okay, that means read 4 times, read 2 times, and read 1 times, or read 4 objects, read 2 objects, read 1 object. Okay, so I am writing here only 16 1. Okay, now this entire 16 byte of data is going to be read by the fread function, and the value is going to be assigned in this array variables. Okay, so in the A0, first 4 byte will be written, so this will now have 97, then A1 will have 98, then 99, and then 100, and since it is of size 5, this will be empty right now. Okay, so after that, if I write here, let's say A of 1, then it will give me output as 98. Okay, similarly, if I do here A of 2, then it will give me output as 99. Okay, so this is how we are able to write the data and read the data. Now let's say that here is integer right now. Okay, integer A, and you want to read 4 bytes at a time and print it to the screen. Now the first method could be like, I write here 4 1, so it will read first byte of first 4 byte and give the output as, assign the value as 97 to the a variable. Okay, and I write here printf of %d and a, so it will give me 97, right? I will again write the same line here, fread, same line, and in that case it will read the next 4 byte, and then it will give me output as 98. Okay, now let's say here is 4 data, so we can write it 4 times, but let's say there are 100 times, the data is 100 times. Okay, there is 101, 102. Now writing fread function again and again is not going to be a good approach. For that we will use the while loop. Okay, so now let's see how we will use while loop. What I will do, I'll write here while and then parenthesis, and here I will write not equals to 0. Okay, and then here I will write printf %d and a. Okay, now in this case our output will be first of all 97, 98, 99, and 100. Okay, so why it is happening is because fread return us the number of records it is reading currently. Okay, for example, if it reading here 1, then it will return us 1. If it is reading 2, then it will return us 2. Now in place, whenever the data is emptied here, then it is not going to be able to read any data. In that case, it is going to return us 0. Okay, means all the data has been exhausted, right? So when it will going to return the 0, then this condition will be true and the control will go here. Okay, so now first of all it will read 4 byte of data only 1 time. Okay, and assign the value to the variable a. So now it will give me output as 97. Loop will again run, then it will read the next 4 byte of data only 1 time, then here it will assign the value as 98, and then here it will give me output as 98. Okay, so this is how we can do using the while loop for infinite or the large number of data. Okay, now same for the structure variables. Let's say there is a structure struct employee or you can say any data int a, then let's say char s, okay, let's say e, okay. And now I'm also, let's say, initializing the values, let's say 45 and the character as a, okay. Now if you want to read the, if you want to write this data, then here you will write end of e, then instead of 4, what you can do here, you can also specify size of operator, okay. Now what will happen, whatever is the size of this file is going to be written here, and you don't have to manually count the size, okay. So size of e here will be 4 plus 1, which will be 5. So I'll write here size of e, okay. How many times you want to read the, write the data, it is only 1, okay. So this data is going to be written here. Here should be, instead of end a, here should be end of e, okay, because we are using the variable as e, okay. So this is the very basic of how we use the fwrite and fwrite function. Now let's talk about the prototype of these two functions. Now fread and fwrite function have the same prototype, okay. So first of all, the return type is size t, then fread, then void asterisk pointer, and then size t size, size t nmap, and then file asterisk fp, okay. Now this you can also say count, like how many times you want to write the data, and you can here specify number of bytes, okay. There is no problem in that, right. Void asterisk ptr means it is a pointer of type void, so it can take the address of any data type, okay. And here this is file stream, right. And the return type is size t. Now you might be wondering, what is size t here, okay, in these three locations. Now size t is equal to, you can say, unsigned int, okay, or simply unsigned. In the various header files like studio.h, string.h, time.h, the type def of size t is written. So basically it is written something like type def, then unsigned, and then size t, okay. It means that in place of unsigned, you can also specify the name as size t. So basically either I can write unsigned a, or I can write size t a, okay. Both are means the same, okay. Unsigned int, unsigned it, okay. For more information about the type def, you can check out the video, right. So size t simply means unsigned, right. So first of all, we will specify the address. Now when I am talking about the fread function, then it means the in which variable you want to write the data, okay. You want to write data which is read by fread, okay. When I am talking about the fread function, okay. Now here we have to specify the number of byte that you want to read, and then how many same byte we want to read, okay. For example, in the previous section we see that we can read the 4 byte again and again, or we can read the 16 byte at once, okay. So I'll write here 16, then here once, or I can write here 4 and then I write here 4, okay. So 16 byte at once, then here number of times, and here we have to specify the file stream. So in the app, when I'm talking about the fread, basically I'm telling the from which file you want to read the data, okay. And if I'm talking about the fwrite function, then in which file you want to write the data, okay. So now what will fread will return? Fread will return number of, basically it will return the value of this, or it will return the number of records it is reading, okay, from the file, which is equal to this count or n member, okay. But note that if the data does not exist, in that case it is going to return as 0, okay. That what we used in the while loop, okay. So basically if first it will return number of count, and if the data is not present, then it will return as 0, okay. Now the fread function is similar to the fwrite function, except that here in the void pointer, or let me write here again size t. So now here I would specify the address of the data whose values are going to be written to the disk, okay. So for example, here I was specifying the end of a, okay, because of the array. Here again the same thing, how many bytes, contiguous byte, you want to write, and here how many number of times you want to write or write to the disk, and here it is the file stream, so in which file you want to write the contents, okay, and the return type will be same as n map. Okay, so this will return us how many number of count it is writing. Okay, so this is how we use the fread and fwrite functions in C programming language. Okay, whenever you are performing the record operations, for example, you are writing some records in the binary file and reading the records from the binary file, then always remember the formatting, or I should say how the data is written. Okay, for example, if you are writing at the starting a character value, then you are reading an integer value, then there will be some mismatch and the data that you will read will not be right. Okay, so the formatting should be match, otherwise the whatever you are going to read, it is not going to be correct. Okay, so that's all for today, guys. I hope you like the video. If you have any doubt, please comment it down. Thanks for watching, and I have to see you in the next video.